between my sophomore and junior year of high school, I went on a trip to D.C. to learn about history and politics. It was here that I met this girl named Yuri, and after a couple days, we became very close. One night, we were hanging out in the little dorm room where I was staying, and she sees a Bible sitting on my desk beside my bed and asks, "Is that a Bible?" I answered yes and proceeded to pick it up, which caused her to reach for it and flip through the pages. This simple act led to her asking me numerous questions about what I believed in, who Jesus was, how the world began, and really, what's so great about this book she was holding. Yuri and I ended up talking for hours until literally 4 in the morning, and as much as I could, I willingly answered every question she threw at me. She was very intrigued, so I asked her if she believed in what I was talking about, in Jesus and in the Bible, and after she told me yes, I asked her if she would be willing to dedicate her life and her future to him. And after she told me yes again, I got to lead her in that prayer. A couple months ago, I was thinking about this story, and I told my youth pastor it, and he suggested that I try to get in contact with Yuri to see how she was doing, see if she was doing anything involving God in her life. And so I did the only thing I could do, sent her a Facebook message. And Yuri didn't reply that day. In fact, Yuri never replied to me after that summer we met each other. But what's the point of this story? Why should you care that a girl didn't reply to my Facebook message? Well, you see, because the point was not to get a response out of her, but to get one out of me. Just because somebody doesn't reply to you doesn't mean God's not working in their life or they're officially closed off to him. It could just mean they're not checking their Facebook. But whether or not you decide to do what God asks you to do determines whether or not you're living out a missionary lifestyle. So, what is the mission field? That brings me to point number one. The mission field is everywhere you go, but to be a true missionary, you have to see that and be willing to do something about it. You don't have to go out into a foreign land or an unreached village to be a missionary. Although some are called to do that, you just have to be willing to move where you're at right now. Okay, so the mission field is everywhere, but what does this have to do with me? Number two, well, since you are now in the mission field, you are now the missionary. You see, God called everyone who believes in him to go out into all the world and preach the good news to all creation in Mark 15:16. It's not just the kid who had a spiritual revelation that gets to do this, it's everyone. But wait, why am I doing this again? Number three, because we're all broken, hurting, and imperfect people. There's still those like Yuri just searching for someone to lead them to the truth and answer their questions. Romans 8:28 says, We know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him and who have been called according to their purpose. And so if you're listening right now and you want to do this, you might be wondering, how can I begin? Number four, start somewhere simple. Start in your group of friends, start with your family. Simply let them know that you believe in Jesus. This alone may be enough for them to start asking questions and believing too. Well, this might be really tough. You might lose friends or some people might make fun of you. This leads me to my last point. Missionary life is not glamorous. In fact, it says in 2 Timothy 3:12, everyone who wants to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will be persecuted. It's going to happen one way or another. He says in Matthew 10:39, whoever finds his life will lose it. Whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. There are people in other countries being brutally murdered and tortured for the gospel. Are you going to be the person who loses their life or help someone else find theirs? Merely learning about these points and starting somewhere simple may only be the beginning of missions, but they still are indeed missions. You're still spreading the gospel. So since we're all called to where we're at right now, I've only got one question left for you. Are you willing? Thank you.